Go on, play the next one.
It includes significant reductions in the nuclear weapons that we will deploy. It cuts our delivery vehicles by roughly half. It includes a comprehensive verification regime, which allows us to further build trust. It enables both sides the flexibility to protect our security, as well as America's unwavering commitment to the security of our European allies. And I look forward to working with the United States Senate to achieve ratification for this important treaty later this year.
Liar. You abandoned our allies. You threw Poland and Czechoslovakia to the wolves. You know, what's interesting to me is that he gets away with this as though it's truth, when it's total lies. It's all falsehood. It's all falsehood. This is something wrong here. If we were arguing over an educational theory, or arguing over some money he was going to spend on some, you know, liberal programs in America, it'd be one thing. Now we're talking about our very survival as a nation. And you know, there's a bigger question. There's a pregnant question that keeps popping up the more I listen to this. We're not at war with Russia, are we? Russia is currently our ally. Isn't Russia our friend? If Russia is our friend, then why do they need us to cut our nuclear arsenal at all? I ask myself. Well, why do they need, if they're our friend and they have no harmful intentions towards us, why do we need to cut our nuclear arsenal to convince them that we're their friend? I thought they are our friend. Right? I mean, they export oil, they export some of the most beautiful women in the world. They're our friend, aren't they? Russia is our friend. So why are we now talking as though they're our enemy and we must now sign a peace treaty? I thought you only signed a peace treaty with someone that you formerly were at war with. Am I making sense to you? In other words, he's not making this announcement as though we've come to the conclusion of a long war and here's what we're settling on. The League of Nations has worked out a treaty. Why is he suddenly signing a peace treaty with Russia when we're not at war with them? We're not at war with Russia. They're our friend. United flies in there every day. Delta flies in there the last I checked if they're still in business. I mean, I don't go there because I'm not interested in eating polonium sushi myself, but there are certain countries I can visit and others I wouldn't visit. That's one I never intend to go to, even though it's the land of my ancestors. I have no desire to ever go back where my grandfather came from, to be honest with you. No desire to ever visit the Ukraine. If I want to see the Ukraine, all I have to do is go to New York City. If I want to see the Ukraine, all I got to do is go to the Richmond District in San Francisco at a certain time of night on a certain street. I have no desire to ever go back to Minsk. But the fact of the matter is, he's signing a treaty and making a big proclamation as though a war has been fought. The war is over and he won it, and now we're allies and we're going to agree to the following cuts in our military capacity. Why is he doing this now? Can anyone answer that question? Because that is the essence of this discussion. Why is Obama doing this now when we are not at war with Russia? Can anyone answer that question? Because I'm the first one to ask it in the American media. I am the only one in the American media who's asked that question. I've racked my brain now for days trying to figure this out. And I knew something didn't make sense. I mean, if we had been at war, I'll repeat it again until you finally get it, and the hostilities had ceased and now this was over and we agreed, all right, the war is over. Remember what Germany had to do after World War I? They had to agree not to have an air force. They had to agree not to have a navy. Remember they had to sink their fleet? Remember that heartbreaking picture, those pictures after World War I? Some of the dreadnoughts that Germany had built had to be sunk. Do you remember those pictures? I guess you didn't get that while you're getting the lesson on how to put a condom on a cucumber. But Germany had to agree at the Treaty of Versailles, because they lost the war, to cut their navy, cut their not develop weapons. The soldiers had to march with wooden rifles to prevent World War II. Remember all of that? But that's because they lost the war. Did we just lose some war that I don't know about? Did Obama lose a war somewhere that I missed while I was taking a nap? What war is it that we lost? What war is it that we lost that we have to sign a treaty with Russia right now? Why are we signing a treaty with Russia right now? Why have we agreed to cut our nuclear arsenal right now? What's the imperative? Were we at some point of a nuclear exchange that I don't know about? Of course not. So this is a unilateral decision to demilitarize the United States of America for no apparent reason. And in the background, there is the dragon. Is China cutting its nuclear arsenal? Did China agree to cut back on its launchers? Did China agree to stop developing ballistic submarines? Did China agree not to develop its navy? I don't think so. So what is this man doing? How is he getting away with this? How is Obama getting away with this? I have to go back to my initial statement. Obama is the destroyer, like a destructive child who takes apart a watch and then cannot put it back together again. Then he takes apart another watch. He has the pieces all over the table, and he says, wow, look what I did, Mommy. I took apart another watch. Let me have another watch. I'll take another one apart now. And the pieces are all over the table. Jumping from one watch to the other, he just destroyed the best medical system in the world. Took it apart, left the pieces on the table, has no idea how to put it back together again. Humpty Dumpty could not put it back together again himself. And now he wants to destroy and take apart our military by signing an insane nuclear treaty with Russia for no apparent reason. Why? Can anyone answer why he is doing this now? That's the question. Why now? Are we at war with Russia? No. Did we just conclude a war with Russia? No. Relations have never been better. So what the hell is this all about?